G'day guys, back again. Hope you're all doing well. I'm building a Dragon StuG 3 at the moment. I was looking at picking up some accessories for it. And I haven't picked up one of these value gear sets before, but I'd pick one up for the StuG 3. And given that I'm just having a look at it myself, I thought I'd give you guys a bit of a look at it as well. If you haven't picked one of these sets up before, they're reasonably priced for the amount of stuff you get. And as you can see on the back here, there's quite a number of sets for the StuG 3. And the other StuGs as well. So, and they do heaps of different sets as well. Some of the older sort of, tarp sets and that you used to sort of get from Valinden and stuff like that, you'd probably get one sort of rather large piece, and then you get a lot of, tiny little, food supplies or something like that. Not a lot of pieces. So this one seemed pretty good to me. Let's take a look inside. All I can say is, after pulling it out of the bag, I'm pretty impressed with the amount of parts you actually get in this. For around the $20 mark, Australian. I mean, it's a pretty nice set when you look at it. And some of the detail and just the things that you get in it that you don't normally get in some other sets. I'm quite impressed, to tell you the truth. I knew it would be okay. But for the price, compared to some of the, the Legend sets that you pay for, and especially now from Valinden, some of the eBay stuff that, some of the eBay stores for Valinden are trying to sell, the prices are absolutely ridiculous. I mean, they've almost tripled on some of the Valinden stuff on what they used to be. And to tell you the truth, there's actually better sets out there than some of the Valinden sets now. But for some reason, the Valinden eBay hobby stores are trying to, sell the Valinden stuff at absolutely ridiculous prices, which is quite a shame. But some of it is reasonably nice, but not for the prices they're asking. So it's quite nice that Value Gear's come along and offering these sets. We'll just have a look close up at some of the pieces. If you look at this piece here, it's reasonably good casting. Given how small these pieces are, if you look at these sort of mess tins, and you can even see the little top of the little canteen lid there, and I'm guessing, I think that's some sort of corn or something like that. It looks to me like something like that. It's got a little bit of texture on it that looks a little bit like corn or something. And sometimes you get some of these pieces from other, like Black Dog and stuff like that, and the casting on them isn't that great on some of the pieces. But I've got to say, the casting on this, it's not 100% as sharp as some of the, the Dragon sets you're going to get out there for 135 scale figures, but for resin and for the amount you're getting, it's actually I don't really have any complaints about it, to tell you the truth. And even this one here, I mean, look at this, look at the rope on that and how tidy it is. There was a little bit of green silicon left there from the mold. You can see just a tiny little bit down there that I've just got to pull that out with a hobby knife. But I mean, that's a pretty nice little set there, the box with grenades and a rope in it. Really nice detail. I'm actually very impressed by this piece. If I can flip it over, it sort of does have, it's quite faint, but it does have the wood grain along the sides of the box as well. And at the back. And look, I've got to say, what I do like about this set already is just, I can't remember really seeing something like this in another 135 scale sort of accessory set with the grenades and the rope and everything like that all in it. And even this one as well. I mean, just these two pieces I've looked at, I've gone, wow, that's a really nice touch. And to have it on the back of a 135 scale tank or something like that, or in a Kubel wagon or whatever vehicle you want, or even in, on the ground in a diorama, I think it's pretty cool. Again, this one here as well, they've sort of got a helmet placed there. And if I turn it around, they've got another little rope along the back of it there. And obviously, and I like the layering of the sort of tarp if it's got a number of folds in it. If I can place it up there for you. It's quite a number of layers in that, so that's quite nice as well. I mean, look, the three pieces I've already looked at, I think they're really nice. I wasn't expecting probably, the quality to some degree. And, there's so many more pieces to go, guys. Another one here. And obviously, depending on which, I think sometimes, depending on what side you like, you can obviously, direct it to, if this one side isn't that great, you can sit it, on the, towards the back of the turret, if you like, or, place something else against the back of it. I thought this was a casting block at the back here for a second, but it's not. I think, is that a an ammo box for, one of the shells or something like that. Because it's quite long, and it's got the handles at the back there. Sorry, that's not in focus, but again, you can see the wood grain along there. Now, because I don't know what type of tarp this is, guys, there does seem to be quite a few air bubbles by the looks of it through this one. But what I do like about some of these things is, you know, you could use these pretty much for anything. You could use these for, you know, a sci-fi diorama, you know, World War II, you know, modern. It's got another, some more cases underneath there. Quite a few air bubbles in that one, which is surprising. I don't know if that's deliberate or not, because it's not in any of the other pieces, I don't think, so far that I've seen. They do like their ropes, but I tell you what, the ropes are done exceptionally well. The hinges there are done quite nicely. There's another one. This is like every second piece I've picked up, there's a rope in there. But again, the casting, I mean the texturing, sorry, the wood texturing on the side there. That's nice. It's a bit of a different one. They've got the rope sort of end on this one. The rope's done quite well. Again, I quite like the folds. If you look at the end of this, it's all rolled up. You know, compared to the Villainen sets I've picked up so far and some of the other tarp sets or accessory sets, I actually really do quite rate this one highly already. The rope's done nicely again at the back there. A little bit of a ding in there. Not exactly sure what this is for, guys. This piece here. Sort of is on its own. Not exactly sure what that's for. If someone knows what it's for, you can chime in and let me know if you've had this set. Again, a couple of little air bubbles. Not major, though, but just, you know, a little bit of putty in these here. You can see the wood grain in there as well. That's nice. This one's got a little jerry can in there underneath it. Just what I like about this kit is there's just probably these accessories and the way they've sort of added them together, the separate items that they've sculpted together. I just think it's something that you just don't see every day in any other sort of sets that I've seen so far. And the fact that they're sort of pushed up against each other, so if you had this on its own and that on its own from a different set, you're not really going to get this sort of nice, tight, pushed up against each other with no gaps in it if you're trying to do it yourself from two resin pieces. And again, I keep on thinking this is just a flat piece of, you know, from the casting that you've got to cut off, but it's not. Again, it's an actual tarp of some description, or blanket, whatever you want to call it. So that's a really nice piece. I know I've said it, guys, but nearly every piece, and I know this sounds crazy because, you know, I actually bought this myself, guys. I haven't been given this to, you know, to sell to you or anything like that. Probably, I don't know, just the buckles is probably the only thing, that probably, you know, to some degree for me, I don't know, like, I'm not exactly sure what they're attempting to do there with the buckles a little bit, but apart from just the buckles themselves, can be a little bit, probably not as sharp as detail, but you know, we're talking resin here, and for, you know, roughly $20 Australian, you're getting a pretty good buy with all this, and the detail that you're getting in these sets, I think is, you know, to some degree, I actually think already it's a bit of a bargain, to tell you the truth. And obviously you don't have to use all these on one tank if you like, but I mean, look at this little fine rope here, or whatever that is, this one as well, and the case there. What have we got on the back here? What I like about this set is that pretty much when you look at this, a lot of casting, they'll have, you know, a casting block on the back or something like that, but because these are mainly sitting on the StuG or a tank if you like, they're flat on the bottom, so what you're getting is you're basically getting a 360 great casting all the way around, which is what you're going to see, and it's just on the bottom where you've got your, you know, your non-detailed part. So this set to me is a really nice set, and it just keeps going. I've got another three pieces to go if you're wondering, guys, so it's not going to take too long. But you know, if you're interested in this set, or you're trying to find one or two particular pieces that, you know, you want for your diorama, thought I'd just show these. And here you go, there's a couple of air bubbles in these little pieces here. But, you know, by the time you put a bit of paint and primer on them, guys, and you can dab a little paint in those, you probably won't even notice it. And, you know, you do get some of these things in some, I think, dragon kits, don't you? Maybe, I don't know, in the 88 set or something like that. But, you know, it's very nice just to get these, two of them, And again, at the end, the wood texture. And the final one here, and this is nice too. I mean, you've got the sort of the different types of straps, if you like. You've got your rope there, and you've got the other sort of strap, different type coming across. And I do like how it's sort of embedded the rope in the actual, whatever you want to call this, blanket, or I don't know what it is. There you have it, guys, the value gear set for the StuG 3, number 10, set 10. And I've got to say to you, I think this is an absolute crack of a set. I'm actually pretty surprised. And I've held off on buying one of these sets for a while because I just wasn't sure about them. But now that I've picked this up, I'll definitely be going out picking up one or two other sets that I've been looking at. Really, really impressed by this set. Hope you guys liked it. Thanks a lot for watching, and I'll catch you later.